Damodar month. We are entering the vows to celebrate Damodar month. Damodars also two types. One is Radha Damodar and one is Yashoda
Damodar.
So we are following the Radha Damodar Vrata here. Krishna is unlimited. Krishna is unlimited. Krishna is Atma Ram. Krishna is self-satisfied. But he is always controlled by the love and affection of the devotees. By the love of Radharani, how Krishna became completely enamored. So in this month, Krishna went to the houses of the gopis and stole the butter from the house of Yashoda. So in this month, Krishna performed Rasila. In the Rasila, Krishna disappeared from the Rasila arena. And when gopis were searching for Sri Krishna, that time gopis sang the songs of separation. So gopis were very scared that Krishna will run away again from Rasila. So therefore they tied very tightly Radharani's well to Krishna's upper cloth so that Krishna will not run away again. So in this way Krishna became completely captured, subjugated, controlled by the love and affection of the gopis. So Bhagavan becomes controlled by the love and affection of the devotees. So therefore this particular month is called Damodar month. It's a very auspicious place, most auspicious place in the world. This is the Samadhi of Sri Rupa Goswami Pad, and this is also the Bhajan Kutir of Sri Rupa Goswami. From the mouth of the different Vaishnavas, we heard many pastimes of Rupa Goswami, who has given the name Rupa. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gave him the name Rupa. So what is the meaning of the word Rupa? Priya Swarupe, who is very dear to Swarup Damodar Goswami. Taita Swarupe, he is also looks like Radharani because he represents the beauty of Radharani. So he has given so many explanations of the word Rup. Priya Swarupe, Daita Swarupe, Prema Swarupe, Sahaja Rupe, Nijan Rupe, Kahurek Rupe, Tatana Rupe, Vilas Rupe. So he is Vilas Rupa Bhagwan. He is Ek Rupa Bhagwan. He is one in form with Radharani or Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. One time Chaitanya Mahaprabhu saw that Rupa Goswami has written one particular drama. In the auspicious invocation of this particular drama, he had penned one very beautiful verse full of ornaments of speech and so many metaphors. Anarpita Chirim Chira Karanayavatirana Kalhu. So Mahaprabhu, when Mahaprabhu heard the glories of the holy name from the mouth of Rupa Goswami, he became thunderstruck. But when one chants the holy name, one feels that I should have thousands of mouths. Every mouth should have thousands and thousands of tongues. I should have thousands and thousands of ears to listen to the thousands and thousands of names of Sri Krishna. So all the associates of Mahaprabhu, and Mahaprabhu began to comment that I heard so many glories of the holy name. But I have not heard the glories like this. So Mahaprabhu called all the associates like Swarup Damodar, Raya Ramananda, and he told Rupa Goswami, please recite the verse again. When all the devotees and Haridas Thakur, when he heard this verse of Rupa Goswami, Tunda Tandavil Ritam Itamate Tunda Vari Labdaye, Haridas Thakur became so ecstatic, he began to dance ecstatically. How Damodar Maharaj said that no one can understand the heart of Mahaprabhu's innermost sentiments. Only Sarva Damodar could understand the innermost sentiment of Mahaprabhu's heart. But Rupa Goswami also understood the innermost sentiment of Mahaprabhu's heart. When Mahaprabhu was dancing with the singing the verse Yako Marhara, why his name is called Rupa Goswami? He is Swarupya Rup. He is Rai Ramanya Rup. He is the Sanatana Goswami's Rup. He is the Jiva Goswami's Rup. So he established the innermost desire of Rupa Goswami. Rupa Goswami established the innermost desire of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's heart in this world. If Rupa Goswami would not have taken body, he would not have appeared in this planet, then who would have preached the glories of the Radharani? No would have understood the innermost moods of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. No would have understood the glories of the Holy Name. So Krishna Kaviraj Goswami, in the last khayal, the last Bengali verse of every single chapter of Chaitanya Charitamrita, he writes that my only shelter is Rupa and Raghunath, and I am writing Chaitanya Charitamrita only based on the mercy of Rupa and Raghunath. When I have attachment for the lotus feet of Rupa and Raghunath, Gautamdas Thakur, Krishna Kaviraj Goswami, Bhaktivinoda Thakur said this. I heard from the lips of great Vaishnavas that only by the mercy of Rupa Goswami, and the Pranam Mantra Prabhupada says that Prabhupada cut all the arguments that were against the philosophy of Rupa Goswami. So in this way protected the disciplic succession and the philosophy of the disciplic succession of Rupa Goswami. So when will we receive the great good fortune to become the full dust of Rupa Goswami's lotus feet? What we can obtain by the mercy of Rupa Goswami? So Gunadas Goswami has highly highlighted the glories of being Rupanuga Vaishnava. Prana Preshtha Sakhi Kulada Pikila Asakunchita Bhumika. Even the Sakhis like Lalita Vishakha, they cannot enter into the Mukunja that Radha Krishna is sporting. So there Radharani's Sakhis cannot enter. But all the responsibility of serving Radha Krishna when they are in Mukunja is bestowed on the able shoulders of Rupa Goswami. So Srila Gurudev is to give an example. You see a tree, that tree is very beautiful, but if that tree is surrounded by a creeper, is hugged by a creeper, then that tree's beauty is multiplied. But if that creeper is blooming with flowers, then that tree becomes even more beautiful, that creeper looks even more beautiful. But if that particular creeper will yield some more birds, then the birds will even further beautify that tree and the creeper. So the beauty of the tree is the creeper. The creeper's beauty is the leaves, and the leaves' beauty is the manjari. So this way manjaris decorate the leaves, they decorate the creeper, they decorate the tree, and this way manjaris are most important for the love play of Radha and Krishna.
जब उन्हें कीर्तन पर महाप्रभु जो उन्हें होश आते महाप्रभु बोला हमारे क्यों ना किले आने तो राधा कुंडे
राधा महाप्रभु वास had become unconscious. So when all the devotees found him in the ocean, then they took him out of the ocean. They brought him back to consciousness. Then Mahaprabhu was telling, why you brought me here? I was at Radha Kunda. I was serving as a manjari, rendering service to Radha Krishna. So when Mahaprabhu also released the manjari bhava, sometimes. nearby is the samadhi of Prabhupada. Prabhupada's contribution, Prabhupada's devotional service is superior than the contribution and the devotional service of all the acharyas combined together. What has Prabhupada has given so far? That Bhakti Pragyan Krishna Goswami Maharaj has said that I was thinking in my mind, I became very confused. It is true. Who is Prabhupada? Prabhupada is the Nayana Mani Manjari. He is the beauty. Nayana means eyes. Mani means the pupil of the eyes. Iris. So he is the beauty of Radharani's iris, Radharani's pupils. So Radharani's sidelong glance is personified by Srila Prabhupada. So Prabhupada is the embodiment of Radharani's mercy. So Srila Prabhupada is the mercy of Radharani personified. So who can compare with Prabhupada? Not all the Vaishnava acharyas in all the three worlds cannot compare with Prabhupada, because he is the merciful glance of Radharani. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu predicted that every town and village, every nook and corner, the name of me will be preached. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu had prophesied. So who fulfilled that prophecy? So who fulfilled the prophecy of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu? Only Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Prabhupada. He only fulfilled the enormous desire all over the world. Fulfill the innermost desire of Prabhupada. So many devotees have come from Australia, London. Here some are living in London, some are living in Australia, some are living in Canada, some are living in South Africa. We could have never thought that we would be able to, we would have come to Vrindavan and hear the glories of Rupa Goswami. All this became possible. It's only become possible by the mercy of Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Prabhupada. Here also Srila Gurudev's Pushpa Samadhi is there. Pushpa Samadhi of Gurudev is there. So Mayan Manjari, under his guidance, that is Vinod Manjari, under the guidance of Vinod Manjari, Shri Ramana Manjari, our Gurudev fulfilled the innermost desire of Mahaprabhu. Therefore his name is Narayan. Why it's called Narayan? When it took birth at home, no one is given the name. So according to the horoscope, such name is given. Brahmachari, his name was Gaur Narayan Brahmachari. When he took sannyas, he became Narayan Maharaj. So in this way, three times his name was Narayan. When he was born, he was Narayan Tiwari. When he took Brahmachari vesh, he became Gaur Narayan Brahmachari. When he took sannyas, he became known as Narayan Maharaj. It's called Nara means human being. Ayana means ashram, means Ayana means shelter. He is the shelter of all living entities. So our Gurudev Narayan Goswami Maharaj, you can see all the qualities of maintenance were seen in Narayan. So he also has Narayan. So there are 12 lunar months. So he disappeared in the Narayan month. So you can see Jiva Goswami is real disciples where Jiva Goswami gave shelter to Narottam Das Thakur, he gave shelter to Shyamananda, he also gave shelter to different Vaishnavas. They were not his direct disciples. Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj, Padmanabha Maharaj, disciple of Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj, but Gurudev gave shelter to him. Madhusudan Maharaj, his guru is Janardhan Maharaj, but Gurudev gave shelter to him. Madhava Maharaj and Tirtha Maharaj, they are disciples of Bhavan Maharaj, but Gurudev gave shelter to them. So you can see there are disciples of Gurudev Maharaj, the Ashram Maharaj, disciples of Gurudev Maharaj, but Gurudev gave shelter to them. So you can see he has preached the knowledge of Harikatha through his followers and to the disciples of